Okay guys, here is the new blue catfish rod from Muddy River Catfishing. The rods on the left are the new blue catfish rod and the rods on the right are the flathead rods. Let's take a closer look at the components. As soon as I get close, you will immediately tell that the blue cat and the flathead rods are very similar. They have the same butt at the end and the grip has different color and the pattern of the texture is a little bit different. But for all practical purposes, I can say that the grips are the same as well. Which is a good thing because I guarantee you, you're gonna like the touch and the feel of these handles. The rod label says it's non-slip and I can absolutely confirm that. Moving on to the reel seats, identical again, only different colors. They are also placed at the same height on the blank. And between you and me, I like the looks of the flathead reel seat a little bit more, but I know this is totally subjective, so I leave this one up to you. You do have the double locking nuts with a washer between them, as you can see. And that coupled with the thick aluminum reel seat makes like a maximum security prison for the reel foot. Going further up, we see that the foregrips are exactly the same as well. So that the total length of the handle of the two rods is exactly the same. And here are the levels of the two rods. Both of them say medium heavy e-glass, heavy duty aluminum reel seat, soft touch no slip speed grip and one piece stainless steel guides. The only difference on the labels is that the flathead rod is 7 foot and the new rod is 7 foot 6. The guides on the two rods are also the same, as you can see, but so are the guides on virtually every other trophy catfish rod on this conference. Seems like all other materials have become a no-no for guides on a trophy catfish rod. After the first guide, the rest of the blank on the new rods is completely white, as you can see here. A look that I personally find very elegant. I know most of you are concerned about visibility only, but I personally really like the all white look on the new blanks. So where does this rod stand? I did test the blank a little bit, as much as I could given the circumstances. And in my opinion, this rod stays at the softer side of the trophy catfish rods. I would say the blank is similar to the shattered cat rod, and both of them are relatively flexy for the class of trophy catfish rods. For me personally, this is a good thing because I just can't stand stiff broomsticks. So yeah, I enjoy the fact that the rod is relatively soft and flexy. If it were me, I would make it even softer and flexier. Because make no mistake, while this rod is on the softer side of trophy catfish rods, it is still a member of what I call trophy catfish rods and is in different category from rods like Rippin' Lips or B&M Silver Cat or Chad Ferguson's Whisker Seeker. Overall, I think Kris designed exactly the rod which the average visitor of the Catfish conference is looking for. But now that Kris created a flathead and a bluehead rod, he's still missing a channel catfish rod. And if he does create a rod for channel catfish one day, I have a feeling that iFish will finally buy a rod at the Catfish conference.